Christina, aka iChrissyMarie, and welcome back to another video. If you're new here, hi, what's up? My name is Christina, and I create home decor, travel, beauty, lifestyle, and fashion videos here on my channel, iChrissyMarie. Today's video, I'm starting off this vlog with a grocery haul. So kind of scaling back on how we ended up here. Yesterday and today was my official move-in day here in Tennessee. So if you don't know, we just moved from New Jersey to Tennessee, and this was our first official move-in day. So as far as like being here full-time, this was our first actual move-in day. We were here previously like 2 weeks ago to start moving things in. However, this is the like actual, like we pretty much cleaned out our old apartment and now we are living here. So that is why it is so echoey in here. We do not have any furniture really. We are starting from scratch, which I kind of am loving because it means I get a whole new like take on decorating my apartment. So it's not like it'll be a carbon copy of like what we used to have. I do have a few things that I bought back with us. So I bought my console table from the old apartment. I bought my Kirkland bench from my old apartment. And those are the two real furniture pieces so far that are in our apartment. I think we're gonna keep our nightstands, but that's really gonna be it. So you guys will see this whole journey unfold with me. So let's get into the grocery haul. All right, so we actually went to three different grocery stores today because there were things that we wanted to make sure that we had, that specific stores had. So we stopped at three different grocery stores. We stopped at Target, Trader Joe's, and Whole Foods, and then I stopped at Home Goods to get some like organizational stuff. Just a few little things that we don't have as of right now. So we'll start, I guess, with Trader Joe's because it's sitting right here. So first I got this fruits and greens smoothie blend. It has blueberries, banana, strawberry, dragon fruit, spinach, and kale. I think this will be really good for breakfast in the morning, so I got that. I picked up this pack of frozen strawberries. Again, smoothies in the morning. And then I picked up some sweet white corn for maybe like a salsa or something. And we got some grade A brown eggs. Vanilla almond clusters. If you have had like honey bunches of oats, it's basically the same thing. So yeah. I got a bag of blue corn tortilla chips. Some oat milk because I don't really drink milk like that. Like I'll drink milk, or I'll use milk in cereal and like in oatmeal and stuff, but when it comes to like coffee and stuff, I prefer oat milk. So and oat milk. And then I got some regular reduced fat milk. This is like 1% milk. What else? I got 2 bottles of San Pellegrino. I love sparkling water, especially San Pellegrino. So I got 2 bottles of that. I got a jar of this cookie butter spread for maybe like toast, or if I want to put them in like my overnight oats. I got that. I got some corn and chili salsa. I got some minced garlic. This is Farron's, it's not mine, but a pineapple probiotic shot and some minced onion along with some pasta sauce. And let's see, is that all I got from Trader Joe's? Yeah, so that's all I got from Trader Joe's. I didn't get a whole lot from there, but the things that I got, I knew that I wanted specifically from there. So I got that. Let's move into Whole Foods, because it's like the thing I have the most of as of right now. So I picked up some Natalie's strawberry lemonade. I haven't tried this yet, so I hope it's good. And I got some Simply Cranberry cocktail juice. A huge thing of watermelon. I got 2 of these cold pressed orange juice. Both me and Varen are obsessed with Whole Foods cold pressed orange juice, like the fresh one that comes out of the machine. So I had to get it because I was like, we love it, like we're obsessed with it. And then we got some skewers. Actually, no, this is salmon. I guess she didn't want skewers. So we got some salmon. We've got another celery juice shot here. This is mine. I got the cold pressed citrus refresh. It has oranges, apples, grapefruit, ginger, and lemons. So I'm super excited to chill this and drink that. I got a pack of boneless, skinless chicken breast, along with some ground turkey. I got this bottle of white sangria, which I'm super excited to pop this open and take a sip tonight so I can be good and sleep, because I feel like I haven't slept in days, like at least not well. So got some of that. We got some pineapple slices, or pineapple chunks, whatever you want to call them. I got some mixed bell peppers. Squash and zucchini. Probably for pasta one day this week. Cantaloupe. Or no, this is honeydew, not cantaloupe. And I got some pico and some guacamole, which I'm super excited. I'm gonna crack this open as soon as I finish with this. I am cooking tonight, so once I finish with this, I'm gonna pop some of that open so I can snack, and then we'll start cooking. And I also got a bottle of this Moscato. This is from Bartanua. I've had this one before, so I know I like that one. We got two of these little packs of mandarin oranges because we like to have them for lunch. I got some mixed carrots, some mixed baby carrots, or again, like roasted vegetables or something. Dinner, and then a Milo's iced tea. All right, I think that's all the groceries from Whole Foods. Now we're gonna go into Target. So to start, I just got a Talenti, which I need to put in the freezer right now because it is melting fast. A little thing of Talenti. Then we've got some classic Catalina dressing. I got four poppies, two of the strawberry lemon, which is my favorite as of right now, but I haven't tried this one yet, but I've heard that it's amazing. This is the cherry limeade one. So I'm gonna try this one maybe tonight, maybe tomorrow. One of these days. I got a pack of some mini Sprites because we're gonna make some refreshers. And then last but not least, Aaron got a pack of Hot Pockets. So yeah, that's pretty much it grocery wise. I'll show you what I got from Home Goods. Just like off the organizational tip. I wanted to start like organizing stuff tomorrow so that as we get more stuff, it's not overwhelming. So I got this Lazy Susan here for my oils that will be in the pantry so that I don't have to like move them around and stuff every time I need to use one, which they're actually sitting right there. I got a egg carton, an acrylic egg carton. That was $5.99 and the Lazy Susan was $9.99. Then I got two of these oil like dispensers. So I got two to use, and then I needed another one of these sponge holders because the one I have does not stick to my sink, and I don't know why. So I got another one just to see if maybe it's just that one. Yeah, like I said, this is just the other oil dispenser. Yeah, I'm gonna put all of this stuff away. And then we are going to start cooking. So I'm starving, but I'm also ready to lay it down and relax. So let's get into this, shall we?
like after I actually soak all my fruit in like the pesticide cleanse, y'all can really sit there and watch me pull everything out. That way everything will already be set inside little containers. On my seat is the biggest one it is. Honestly, there's so many bowls in here and it wasn't that bad of a price. I'm not even sure if I will return this, but I think. They say Noki is apparently like. Actually, didn't use all of it. They gave me a good portion at Trader Joe's. That looks good though.
Another Sunday, another mall. Karen has never been here before, so she insisted that we go to John Rockets in Nashville, even though there are things known to Nashville that we should be eating. She insisted that we go to John Rockets. Should be eating like Nashville hot chicken and stuff like that.
Oh my god, get that
natives.
We'll have it tomorrow. Sure, the week is over. Should we get her Nashville
bar taco, like things that are like
tacos.
Bar taco. It's like a really big thing here.
Taco Tuesday tomorrow.
No. Tomorrow's Monday.
2 days. 2 days you'll get your barn tacos. I think a Nashville hot chicken sandwich should be Thursday or Friday. Because we got food we need to cook.
Maybe Friday.
We get Friday. Yeah, it's a pay day. Yeah.
Sorry. Okay, so honest review.
What's the name of the place? Johnny Rockets. Honest review. Honestly, 7 out of 10. Only because the service, I had to bring my burger back 3 times with specific directions. When you say no mayonnaise means no mayonnaise. When you say, you know, grilled onions, that means grilled onions. When you say ketchup and mustard, I'm expecting ketchup and mustard. So yeah, they got dinged 3 times because the mayonnaise was a no for me. None, absolutely not. other than that, I guess it was alright, but service is everything. What'd you say?
My stuff was fine.
Right, hers came out perfect. Damn, I asked for three specifics, and they missed every single one of them. It's not that hard, but whatever. On to our next destination, huh, babe?
I'm going to try to return the shirt that I told Aaron to take to an actual express. The first time. That's where we're at.
Adios, amigos.
It is. It could be a little cooler in here. Oh, this is like really cool. Like, this is a really cool showroom. All right, so we're at RH, just looking around. And this is a really cool showroom. I've never been to like one of their flagship stores, but it's actually really cool. They have a restaurant here. I'll try to get a glimpse of it for you guys. This is their restaurant. It's so cool. Yeah. Yeah. Wow, they have a balcony. That's kind of cool. It's so pretty in here. This one too. This one's really cool. I like that one, like a lot. I got that book.
feel too much. I know. I'll tell you when I'm ready. Hold on. Wait, how am I closing?
Just
hold for a sec. I need to. Oh.
All right, so we are on the, I guess, rooftop gallery of RH. Farron wanted some pictures, so.
No, that was a good one.
We're on the rooftop. I want to get the mountains over there, like a picture of the mountains over there. So I'm going to go to the other side.
Is
there
a waterfall
over there?
Probably.
I don't know. Haven't gone to the one in New York yet. Cause this is really cool. This is so pretty. Really cool mall trip. I think this is gonna be our favorite mall, like our go-to mall from now on. So I got another RH book because I'm obsessed with home decor books and this one fit the aesthetic. So picked up one of those. Now we're headed to the car. Still gotta go to like Target, I believe, and that'll be it. We'll go home after that. So, oh, Target and the grocery store. So yeah, Target and the grocery store. Then we are homeward bound because I was getting tired, boss. So, ooh, and I got some really nice pictures. It was great. What's up, guys? So we just made it home. I just put all of our groceries and stuff away. So now I'm going to fill up my spice containers here because they're looking kind of empty. So we're going to take the time to do that so we can go ahead and have that done. Got the labels here. I'll link the ones that I got and where I got them from on Amazon. Because I think these are really nice and they're a really good size. And the fact that they come with the labels is a bonus. So yeah, let me get that. All right, so I bought my iPad because I want to try to like watch YouTube or something while I'm in here cooking and stuff. So let's try to find something to watch. Ooh, okay. So Evelyn Hernandez posted a Amazon home decor favorites video, so I'm gonna watch that. So while this goes on, while this is going, I'm gonna montage this so you don't have to hear all of it. Sure. It's really simple. I already made mine. So what I do is I add some cube limes. I'm gonna add pineapple to this one. I didn't add pineapple yesterday, but I'm gonna add pineapple to this one. And then what gives it like a really refreshing taste? Cucumber, so I'm gonna add cucumber. If I had some mint, I would also put mint in here, but I don't have any, so we're just going to use what we got. So put in cucumbers, add some lemon juice. Cut up lemon. Just a little bit. Then we're going to mash all of this up. Sparkling water or Sprite, but right now I like it with Sprite, so I'm gonna do Sprite. Let the bubbles go down a little bit, then top it off with some more. And then you can garnish it if you want, but I'm not doing all that right now. So, just mix. And perfect. There you go. Dinner tonight. I sliced up some chicken breast in half and seasoned it with adobo, garlic powder, Cajun seasoning, salt and pepper. And then I like baked that or like cooked it on the stove in butter so that it got a little bit of the butter flavor. Then I took the chicken out and cooked, sauteed the zucchini and squash in butter as well, along with like whatever chicken flavoring was in there. All right, and then I made some rice. So that's it. Let's go ahead and plate this. And then we're gonna go eat because I am starving. Actually, because I am fancy, I'm gonna do rice first. And get some of that juice. Chicken on top of the rice. And then we're gonna add vegetables over top. What do you want, Deuce? Anytime I'm cooking, he has to be like right there. Anytime. It's done. So I'm gonna give this a little bit of a taste. Just without the fruit.
What is it?
Same, right? Just without the fruit.
Okay.
It's good though. It's not too sweet, but not too tart. It's really good, so try this one. Like I said, it's called Lolea.
Lolea. And you get it at Whole Foods.
So, I'm gonna take it down. I'm gonna say goodnight to the people.
Night.
Good morning, guys. Happy Monday. Today is the 22nd. I am off today, like I told you guys before. I don't start until... Excuse you? Deuce, really? I don't start until next Tuesday, so I was off today, and I took Farron to her job because she started today, and then I kind of like drove where my job would be just to kind of get a little bit of a idea of what the route is and what the building looks like and house parking and just like all the good things. Try to find out all the good things. So I found out that my job is 22 minutes from Theron's, and her job is like maybe 20 minutes from the house. So, yeah. All right, guys, we're in Hobby Lobby. Just kind of browsing, but I did want to see if they had this vase on sale. And it does look like ceramics are on sale this week, 50% off. And this is the viral Hobby Lobby vase. I think it's originally like $189, which is more than it was when I first saw it. It's like 90 something dollars the first time I saw it. And now it's $189. But that's what happens when things go viral. The price escalates later. Dog owner like me, this will save your life. Like, especially if you are like working full time. Put that outside on the balcony, or if you have a balcony, or put it in a box in like a designated corner and don't move it. And train your dog to go to the bathroom there and just change it regularly. How we did it with Deuce. All right, so I found this painting and I actually really like it, so I think I'm gonna put this in the cart because it's super pretty. Sorry, Poo Poo. And then Deuce is in the car. All right, you guys, we're home. We are home. And I wanted to show you guys what I got from Hobby Lobby. I'm not sure if I like actually showed you what I got or not. So I picked up this painting, which I think I showed you guys. I'm gonna see if I like it over in that corner. Like that little space over there, because I have like a grouping of three that I have in mind for over there. So if I like it over there, I'll keep it over there. If not, it'll probably go on like my console table or something. But yeah, so let's try this out first and see. This was on sale this week, so instead of $19.99, and they paid like half of that, so we're gonna have this way, just slightly. kind of like that. I felt like I needed like a painting here, and I kind of like that all together. Slightly in front of it, so I can move this over a little. I love that. I think that's so cute.
Deuce.
I think that is so cute. The only thing that I am slightly concerned about is how gold the frame is. But later down the line, if I feel like it's too gold, I'll just get some rub and buff and buff it out a little bit. But I think it's nice. It's a nice contrast between the wood and the white, and the scenery reminds me of like on the way here, like the drive here, how it's very like mountainous and it's got like farm animals and all the greenery, and I love it. So it definitely is a great decor piece to have in a Nashville house. So I love that. And I've got, of course, like my butter dish here, my little fruit strainer or like fruit bowl. We've got our utensils here in this space, and a wood cutting board that I've had for about 2 or 3 years now. So I like that, and I'm really happy that I decided to put the paper towel rack underneath the cabinet, because I did have a like stand-up paper towel holder, and I just think it just looks so much better up there. Even if I decide later that I want to just put it in a cabinet, I can take that sticky piece off and just add the extra one that they gave me and put it in the cabinet, which would be kind of cool to keep it like hidden. But right now I think it's okay right there, and then it doesn't affect how this looks. So I really like this. I'm gonna keep it like this. All right, so the next thing that I got from Hobby Lobby is a basket. I had some faux cosmos that I got a couple of weeks ago, maybe a couple of months ago at this point now. If you guys know like the super viral Hobby Lobby cosmos, I got a few bundles of those, or a few stems of those, when I first saw that they were super popular, and I was like, wow, like that's so nice. Like I liked how they looked. I thought they were so perfect for the springtime, but also a really good transition, a really good transition stem for the summer as well, because they looked so freshly picked. Like, especially if you style them in a certain way, they look so freshly picked. So I got that, and like I said, I got a basket. So I'm gonna show you how I styled it, because I already kind of staged it, because I wanted to see if I liked them, one, if I had enough stems, two, or if I had enough stems, two, and how I wanted to arrange them to make them look even more realistic. And I also didn't know if I wanted to exactly put those in the basket that I got from Hobby Lobby today. I didn't know if I was gonna use it for all of my fruit or if I was gonna use it for stems. But what's nice about having a basket in your kitchen is that it's really versatile. You can change it up. Like in the summertime, I might wanna put all of my oranges and my lemons and my limes in there to be, you know, like a fruit basket, which is nice. And also because of the shape and the style, it looks very freshly picked. So I actually had another basket in my cart, but I could not stand the color. So I'm really glad I spun the block and looked again, because I found this basket the second time that I got in that aisle. And I love that. I love this one so much more. It is so nice. And I think I'm also gonna add like a tea towel or a kitchen towel in here as well, just to kind of add a little bit of texture to the basket besides the weaving of it. I want to add like a little bit of a fabric texture. So this is what it looks like. So these are the Cosmos I was talking about. I have them in the white. I have them in the cream, which is like these. It's like an off-white creamy color. And then I have them in this like really beautiful tannish, almost tannish pink. They have a mauve one too, if you've seen that one. But I like the tannish pink. I think it fits really nicely. And again, it's a great transition color for the space. And this is how I styled it. I put them in this basket that, again, that I said I got from Hobby Lobby today. Let me move this leash off the table. I styled them in this basket, which I feel like it's really pretty. And like I said, I think I'm gonna put a kitchen towel like right here where there's this almost like empty space. But it's so nice and I love how it came out. It looks like I went outside and picked some fresh flowers, some fresh cosmos, and I just love how realistic this looks, but also how it adds some warmth. Like, don't get me wrong, I liked my vase of hydrangeas here. I thought it was really grand. It added a great sense of, you know, drama. It was eye-catching. But I feel like this just adds a little bit more warmth to the space. And I love it there. I think it's so pretty. So yeah, this is how I styled this. And this basket was on sale, actually. So this basket was $29.99. It was 50% off for table decor this week. So I got it for $15. I think it was $16 with tax. But so beautiful, such a beautiful piece. If you find this one in Hobby Lobby, definitely snag it. It is so versatile. You can use it for, like I said, almost anything. You can use it for faux florals. You can use it for your fruits. Use it as a fruit basket. If you do actually have a garden outside, you can use it to pick your mint leaves or your herbs, your basil, your tomatoes, lemons, limes, oranges, whatever you grow outside, this will definitely give your kitchen like a warm feel, but also an organic feel, which is what I'm really trying to go for, especially with all of this bright white in this kitchen, white and gray. So it instantly adds some warmth and character to this kitchen, along with my painting over there. So I love it. I think I'm gonna end off this vlog for today and then start a like new vlog, start next week's vlog today, so that I can have that start editing that for next week, because I do start work next week. So I gotta get a little organized as far as that. So I will see you guys in the next one. Thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. I'll see you guys later. Bye.